ABCD parameters. Okay, we will take the same circuit, and now these are the ABCD parameters. So V1 is equal to A into V2 minus BI2, I1 is equal to CV2 minus DI2. So these are the ABCD parameters. From this we need to calculate ABCD values. Okay, A is equal to V1 by V2 when I2 is equal to 0. Similarly, B is equal to V1 by I2 at V2 is equal to 0. Similarly, from this C and D values we got. So here the condition is I2 is equal to 0, here also I2 is equal to 0. So we will calculate these two parameters first, A and C. Okay. So when I2 is equal to 0, that means this current I2 should be 0, that means this should be open circuited. So here we have open circuited, the same thing. Okay. So now we need to measure. Okay. So V1, V2, we need to measure V2. So we need to place one voltmeter here. So with plus and minus here, this will be V2. And we need to measure I1 also. So for measuring I1, we need to place one ammeter here with plus and minus like this. So this will be I1 and this will be V2. Okay. Now we will connect this circuit. So 15 volts positive is given to the ammeter positive. Okay. So ammeter negative is given to first 1 kilo ohm first terminal. 1 kilo ohm second terminal is given to another 1 kilo ohm first terminal. Another second 1 kilo ohm second terminal is given to the voltmeter positive. Voltmeter negative is connected to 220 ohms second terminal, and from the same second terminal of the 220 ohms is given to 15 volts supply negative, and the 220 ohms first terminal is given to 1 kilo ohm second terminal. Okay, now let us switch on. So if you see the current I1 is equal to 12.3 milliamperes and V2 is equal to 2.72 volts. So from these two values you can get A and C. Okay, so now we need to measure B and D. For measuring B and D, the condition is V2 is equal to 0, so we need to short circuit this second port. Okay, so if you observe this circuit and this circuit, here it is open circuit and this is short circuit. Okay. Here we have connected voltmeter. Here in this circuit you need to measure I1 and I2. For I1 you need to place one ammeter here, and here for I2 you need to place one ammeter here also. The current I2 is in this direction, so we need to place plus here and minus here. Okay, so just here voltmeter is there, here ammeter is there, remaining so all the circuit is same. So we will just remove this voltmeter and we will connect this ammeter in reverse direction. So this is the voltmeter. So voltmeter positive is given to ammeter negative, and voltmeter negative is given to ammeter positive. So now the second circuit is connected and the readings are 12.7 milliamperes for I1, and for I2 it is minus 2.3 milliamperes. Okay, so from these two values you can get B and D. So now we will go to the pi circuit. So we will connect the pi circuits. I think you know already all the theory behind that pi circuit. Now we will connect the pi circuit for I2 is equal to 0. For I2 is equal to 0, the circuit is here, and we need to connect one ammeter here for measuring I1, and we need to connect one voltmeter here for measuring V2. Now let us connect this circuit. So the 15 volts first positive is given to the ammeter positive, and from ammeter negative we need to give 220 ohms first terminal, and 220 ohms second terminal is given to voltmeter. Voltmeter positive and voltmeter negative is given to the 15 volts negative, and first 1 kilo ohm first terminal is given to ammeter negative, and the first 1 kilo ohm second terminal is connected to 15 volts negative. And the second 1 kilo ohm first terminal is connected to 220 ohms second terminal. And the second 1 kilo ohm second terminal is connected to 15 volts negative. Now let us switch on. So if you observe, the readings are 27.3 amperes, milliamperes, 27.3 milliamperes, and V2 is 12.28 volts. So now we'll replace this voltmeter and ammeter. So this voltmeter positive is connected to ammeter negative, and this is connected to, so the readings are like that. So I1 is equal to 82.3 milliamperes, and I2 is equal to minus 68.6 milliamperes. So from these two values you can calculate B and D. Okay, so from these two values you can calculate A and C. Here B and D.